My name is Janet. Mm-hmm. So I'm the general manager of
full name
San
ba?
Cruces. Mm-hmm. Janet Borlaglani. So general manager of San Cruces Inn. So San Cruces is yung partner ng ating ano, ito kasing corregidor is assigned sa Department of National Defense, and then assigned naman ang Department of Tourism under yung TIESA. And then kinreate naman ng TIESA ang Corregidor Foundation. Corregidor Foundation Inc. naman is with contract with San Cruces para to bring in tourists dito sa Corregidor. So San Cruces is the sole tour operator dito sa island, and for more than 30 years we've been bringing yung tourists para to sustain din yung island.
Okay. Si what? Sir Ed, yes. ano yung, di ba kasi nga?
Pakilala mo muna, girl.
Okay. Sir Ed, papakilala mo nyo muna po yung sarili ninyo.
I'm Eduardo Gurion, resident manager po ng San Cruces, and also accredited tour guide po sa Corregidor.
Okay. So, Kuya Sisiko kasi yung nagtutour, ano yung mga highlights, let's say, give 5 highlights na dapat nilang experience dito, yung sa pag ano nila ng tour or overnight, gano'n. Ano yung mga ma-experience nila, parang gano'n. Besides kasi normal na kasi yun eh, Damalinta tunnel. So ano pa yung mga special ano natin ngayon, activities? May bago ba? For 30 years may nabago ba? May dinagdag ba tayo?
Okay, ang corridor po kasi is very historical. So ang corridor hindi lang po yung historical value ang pinapakita namin dito, kundi yung mga other adventures na pwede pang gawin po dito. Kasi ito full of history, so ang makikita dito are the ruins and guns and also tunnels, which is yung po yung mga ginamit during the war. So after the war naman, marami na rin ang corridor is pwede na rin gamitin or gawing adventure island. So marami na rin pong pwedeng gawin na mga activities like team building, yung mga mahilig sa biking, mga backpackers. So we have you can do also biking in the island because we have roads and trails na pwedeng puntahan. Pwede rin yung mga hiking kasi hindi lang yung nasa malapit sa kalsada or main historical site or main attraction na nakikita, pwede pa naming ipakita yung mga hidden na which is not part of the historical tour. So inside the jungles, there are still many tunnels and gun batteries na hindi pa makikita during the historical tour. And also, meron din kaming mga beach na pwede kayong mag-swimming. So, pwede kayong mag-overnight stay because we have also the hotel. So, if you stay overnight and day tour in corridor, it's a total package because you have the tour, you can do activities, you can do day swimming, you can do boating, ganyan. So, marami kayong magagawa pa.
Ma'am, si ma'am na. Si ma'am Presi, question namin for you would be the packages naman.
Hi, my name is Presi Mendoza. I'm the account executive of San Cruces. San Cruces offered a lot of packages, which is yung number one, yung day tour namin. Ang rate niya is 3,358 for weekdays and 3,629 for weekends. Ang inclusion nun yung round trip ferry, buffet lunch, and then yung tour and entrance fee sa Corregidor. Also, may mga offer din kami yung sa accommodation, yung na-experience nyo ngayon, which is 7,500 for 2 person, included na yun yung round trip ferry and the overnight accommodation at saka yung full board meal. Pagka gusto nyong mag-tour, kasi hindi pa siya kasama, mag-a-add-on lang kayo ng 650 per person. Meron doon yung outdoor activities natin with light lateral, mag-a-add lang tayo ng 800 per person. So yung 7,500, good for 2 person na yun, pero parang 3,375 per person, complete package na siya. Nag-offer din kami ng walking tour, bike tour, may mga packages pa kami doon. separate.
Paano yung walking tour and yung bike tour? How do they book that? Or because we didn't see a lot of them. Now, we saw mostly the trams, right?
Mm.
So, kahit dalawa lang kayo, pwede kayong mag...
May minimum kami for bike tours and walking tours, which is 5 person per group dapat.
How much then?
Magkano naman yun?
That's, ano, for... For walking tour, it's... For walking tour, it's 2,100. Mm-hmm. And then, for bike tour, it's 2,500.
That's per person.
Per person. So, cheaper siya.
Sorry for bike
tour. Historical track. Mm-hmm.
So, bike tour, you still do the same route, right? Kung walking tour, tama.
Yeah, we're doing same route as the bus tour, but there's an additional po. Kasi meron kaming trails inside the jungle.
Mm-hmm.
Yun para sa bike tour and walking tour.
Mm-hmm.
Just like what we experienced, the hospital tour, that's not part of the walking tour. And now, the day tour, the tram tour, and also the tail of the island.
But it's part of the bike tour?
Bike tour and walking tour.
Sorry, biking tour, 2,500.
Yes.
2,500.
Minimum of 5. Kayo magdadala ng bike.
Yes. Dito rin. From tail
to head. Sa pag-walking, mag-walk sila. Amo na dito.
No. Walking tour. From the docking area, pick up, then we will drop in one historical site, like Battery Way, then all the way walking na yan. Ang kaibahan talaga is you experience some of the tunnels.
Mm-hmm.
Just like we did the Japanese tunnel as part of the walking tour. And they can go up, they will experience na pumasok sa mga building. Like, just like we did in the hospital. Ito, part ng walking tour namin ito.
How long po yung duration ng walking tour?
Same as the, ano naman po, as the historical tour.
Sa biking po, for example, dalawa lang sila, minimum 5 packs. Pwede kaya sila maki-joiner sa ibang group or...
We can do that.
Pwede naman po,
ma'am. Kung on schedule, let's say may dalawa, and then we can upload na lang na, okay,
looks
we need more.
Yeah.
Tapos i-confirm na lang once. Ano. Pero I think we can do that. May pwede special naman,
Pwede naman po, special arrangement with the tour guide. We will provide tour guide kasi po for every activity.
We bikers, don't allow
walking tour, hiking.
Like DIY.
Whatever activity we provide kasi tour guide.
That's for safety reason. Yeah. We don't want our guests na, you know, to get Early lost. So we have like 584 tama no? 584 hectares na property.
Minaligaw
na
ba?
Wala kasi we don't allow them to roam around alone. So ano yan? We will be responsible naman
for the safety.
Mahirap.
Dapat ma-guided tour talaga. Meron silang malalamang history.
Kasi sayang pictures. It's not just about biking. While doing the walk and yung biking, they're given history. Yung information on the history.
Pero dito na po ba yung bike or bit nila sa... is it your own bike or can they rent?
Yeah. Right now, what we encourage is people to bring their own bike. Kasi unang-una, mas familiar sila dun sa ano nila, sa bike, sa naaaralin pa nila. But we're looking into that, investing on some units para dun sa mga like especially mga overnight stayers na if they want to do biking in the afternoon. Nice lang talaga namin kasi slowly, like, we have just relaunched yung, ano, yung accommodation. Now, we're slowly putting more activities.
Yeah.
Kasi, like, after here, so, you've seen naman the rooms, diba? We really don't have television. Mm-hmm. We want the people to go out and then explore yung island. So, those things are in the pipeline.
Okay. Yun nga, ma'am, you mentioned na nga yung mga developments. Ano itong mga nasa pipeline natin?
Okay. So after the hotel, it's now being used. Yung swimming pool is top of the line. Hopefully we're looking like within March or hopefully first week of April it will be there. And then yung mga adventure games na we're adding more activities, we're putting more ano pa mga games para exciting. Though we have several na, a lot actually. Kasi may mga hindi naman first timers here. Eh. Ayaw mo naman na, okay, ay nalaro na namin to. So, and then we tailor fit din kasi yung mga games namin sa kung ano yung objective ng mga group. Like, gusto nyo ba ng teamwork? Is it about leadership? So, and then Ed is there on top of those team na nag-aano sila, nag-host. And then at the end of ano, may konting processing na, you know, like na-achieve ba yung goal nyo. So it's a combination, yung adventure game is a combination of physical, mental, and whatever. So yun,
may and emotional. Can facilitate nun mismo?
Yes, we do. Yeah. Si and Brian can, and si Ed.
And we can combine also the historical tour and the adventure tour. We can combine in one day or in an overnight. Oh, nagtutur ka na, nagigame ka pa.
Yeah.
That's the exciting one. That's the exciting one.
Additional payment.
Yes.
Card.
How much is yung adventure?
$750.
Supposedly, yun yung gagawin natin this morning. Kaya lang, we opted na, ay, free time yun na lang. Kasi we asked them, sabi, pagod na ba kayo yesterday or kaya pa ng powers nyo this morning? Para you can get it. But anyway, there will always be next time naman. So that everyone can experience yung other ano natin, yeah, activities.
May events mo kayo like wedding,
birthday.
Yes, may nga daw, di ba?
Yes, may package kami for wedding. And this is one of the favorite places for mga pre-nuptial photos, pretty boo.
Magkano po kaya yung
pre-nup
naman? Ah, interesado.
Pero meron tayo, existing na package.
Asking for a friend.
Last time it was like 12. Bibigyan kayo Sir Ed doon sa tour natin.
Siguro around mga 15,000. Good for 5 na yun.
Prenup lang yun, ano?
Oo, for prenup.
Oo.
Kasi may sariling trambiya siya eh. Exclusive. Hindi kayo sasama. Hindi sasama yun sa tour.
Oo, matagal yan eh.
Tsaka alam na namin kung saan yung pwedeng.
Now, in the event na kailangan mag-overnight, okay, we charge them accordingly na lang ng ano, accommodation and yung mga extras. Tapos pag sometimes hindi naman enough yung 5 persons lang, so meron kang stylist and all, ano na lang siya, add-ons na lang.
What's the maximum number of people you can house?
Yeah.
Okay, so for the hotel, dun sa Corregidor Inn, we have 31 rooms, so kung double occupancy, we can house mga 60. But there are times na mas, let's say, bigger yung groups. We had one time more than 100. Nag-squeeze in sila ng 4 inside the room. They didn't mind. Gusto nila eh, okay lang. So, sikan sila. So, it's not that as comfy na yung kagaya ng twin sharing. Pero, if there are groups na more than nung capacity and they are willing naman to squeeze in, we accommodate. Actually, triple is good enough. Tapos, we have one suite room naman na can accommodate up to 6 persons, 5 to 6 yon. Family room siya with ante.
Yeah, I was gonna ask that. What's your provision for families? Because most of the time, diba, like, let's say parents and 2 kids. I mean, okay lang kung adults yung kids, but
okay. So, children ages 11, dalawa? 3 to 11, free yan. Kapag sharing with parents dun sa ano, sa accommodation. So, 12 onwards, treated as adult, like what other hotels are doing naman. And then, we have yung hostel. So, 2 wings yon. Both can accommodate ng 26 ano siya, parang
double
decks. So, 13 double decks siya. And so, beds niya is 26. So, 13 times 2, 26. Then, 2 of those. In the event na mas malaki naman, kasi may space pa, we can still add like mga 4 extra beds, no? So, max ng 30. So, 60 pa yun. Then we have yung conference room din dun sa area. If this is for mga lower yung budget nila or school activities, ganun, mga for retreats, yeah, we use those.
Ma'am, ano lang, we know recently na naging controversial ang Manila Bay.
Oh, yes.
For the pollution, everything. You're part of Manila Bay as well. May mga environmental measures or program ba tayong pinapatupad? Yes. Like you have STP po ba dito?
Okay.
Recycling ka lang?
Yes, of course we have yung STP. We are in conformance to all yung government mandated or yung mga regulations nila. Mm-hmm. And Well, I'm banking also on the fact that, okay, we belong to Magsaysay Group of Companies. We wouldn't trade our reputation like 70 years in the industry if we were like not complying. And then, even yung mga boats namin, in compliance yan to DENR, ano, mga regulations, how we throw away yung mga garbage na hindi kami sa dagat nagtatapon. So, compliant kami doon. And ang permits namin, of course, all are ano naman, updated yan. And then, we welcome also yung mga government agency to do spot checking, whether mga Bureau of Fires yan. So, I'd like to, ano, well, I'm proud to say na for the past like 30 years or so, we haven't had any issues on like this, yung regarding doon sa Manila Bay issue. It's actually kami nga yung affected ng Manila Bay. Kasi mm-hmm. since no one is like, you know, wala namang community dito na with family. So, ang nandito are employees lang. So, then we have our own waste management procedure then. So, if ever, yung mga trash na nakikita natin sa dagat, it's not coming from us.
Nakita ko nang pupulo sila kanina.
Yes, from Manila Bay yon. So, like, especially pag ang waves papunta dito sa lahat ng neighboring towns, cities, papunta dito ang basura nila. So, there are times na magpupulot sa umaga, mag-clean up, like, after an hour, andyan na naman yan. So yun yung ano, but we are thankful that yung government is now finally looking into yung rehabilitation ng Manila Bay kasi it's somehow how help mas maganda ngayon kasi previously pagdating mo pa lang, well, I would not ano naman yun, I would deny dahil nga nung madumi pa ang Manila Bay, there are times dun pa lang sa docking area you would see na yung galing sa ano. Even maglinis ka ng 6 a.m. para pagdating sana ng 9 o'clock, malinis, but still, yeah, may darating yun. But now, I think when we arrived, di ba, parang it's cleaner now after that Manila Bay rehabilitation.
Mm-hmm.
And hopefully lang, tuloy-tuloy siya. Kasi sana wag mingas kugon, di ba? Ngayon, tapos pa, pagdating ng June, eto na naman tayo.
We notice you serve good food nowadays.
Oh, in fairness, thank you.
I love your sinigang.
I love the sotanghon.
Kaya
the sahog.
For the you know the ingredients, the materials we ano, do we outsource that or mean we are practicing organic farms ba dito, mga ganon?
Well, it's our dream to have that organic farm here, greenhouse. So, everything we serve here comes from Manila. So, meron kaming mga accredited supplier. We pass through our central processing unit, purchasing unit, and then we order. Tapos, they bring in the food for us. But it's, ano, it's check. And, talang, yung chef, actually, not chef, cook, is, ano, she has been here for how many years na si Joseph?
Almost, ano, 12 years na.
12 years. So, the same team, and, ano lang, nag-upgrade lang na skills.
Kasi we were here, like, before the election.
Mm-hmm. And then, I, you know, personally, I really, like, look into the food. Kasi being in the service hospitality industry, and the food industry for like maybe more than 20 years. So, nangingialam talaga ako sa kitchen. So, I taste and then I give comments. So, which is actually being done also by Edna. Make sure that the food is good. Kasi, you know, like the history, yung historical value is there. But what will make the people come back is not, aside from the food, is yung service ng tao here. Which we would like to
memorable.
Opo. Pambalikan ko lang yung dream nyo magkaroon ng farm. Pero, I mean, di ba, you've been here, you have all the spaces. Bawal ba sa contract nyo or agreement nyo?
It's not about bawal sa contract. Right now, medyo ang challenge kasi namin is water.
Okay.
Order. So hopefully after it's, you know, like, di ba, meron namang mga development that's going on, care of yung sa Tiesa, hopefully ma-address din yun. So right now, we have enough water to support yung guests natin, like maybe pag na-open yung pool, but to sustain yung, let's say, if we're given, let's say, more hectares of land para baka masayang, di ba? So sana we should be ready before we implement something new.
You mean po walang source of water dito?
Meron naman, may water, but of course, yung like mga pumps, mga equipment, it's not enough lang na may bukal. it has to be, you know, like yung may machinery falls, ka dapat.
Okay.
So may mga pubs naman, but enough right now for yung sa current needs namin.
Ang question lang kasi 'di ba yung nga yung the electricity generator, walang plan to use yung solar or
I'm seeing some solar, yeah,
solar
for lightings.
Is used to be other companies yan, ano? Oo, to kaya lang right now talaga it's quite expensive. Medyo challenging yung mag-ano na solar with the you know space that we have, but we are you know like coordinating with the Corregidor Foundation on how to help each other para naman we can save on the fuel kasi medyo expensive to maintain yung operations by kasi we buy yung ano fuel dinadala rito sa powerhouse namin which we use for ano to run our business. Hopefully then ma-address yan when the master plan na when the master plan is ready and it's you know like awarded to you know one investor, I hope na ma-address then yung ano yung aming challenge on the electric power at saka sa water.
Going back to San Cruz, ano pa yung ibang ruta ng San Cruces?
Okay, so our main ano talaga product is yung and service is itong Corregidor. Mm-hmm. Parang it has been like aside from business, so it has been like parang advocacy na nung company na to preserve yung Corregidor that the younger generation should not ano forget about the mga heroic deeds ng mga forefathers natin. So, yung right na yung mga veterans are still there. So, hopefully, they would last longer. But, we are trying to top na yung mga millennials para makontinue. Kasi, you've been in the area and it's sayang kung, di ba, after tong generation is gone, who would continue to patronize na yung, ano, yung island. So, that's why we are really encouraging younger generations to visit and yan, may mga marketing initiatives din kami to top mga younger generations.
Can you give us a figure, like how many tourists or guests are we having for a year?
For a year? So we are targeting like mga 57,000 at least per year. Pero binibigyan nga kami ng 80,000 na figure. So I hope, well, with all your help, I know, we can, ano, we can do it. Kasi
what's like, your maximum in a day?
Maximum kaya namin capacity is 280 dun sa